Hi guys, welcome to our latest Whiteboard Friday. Today we want to talk to you about how you can use insights to create a great website. One of the key challenges of creating a website or coming up with a great web design is doing a design that actually addresses your audience, that actually identifies and replicates the behavior that your audience would generally do on the website. So let's take a look at what are the common design directions that people normally take.
First one is building a beautiful website. In general, agencies go to the customer and collect all the requirements and come up with best possible beautiful website for the customer. So because then they can actually impress their customer and close the deal.
And also we have seen a lot of people or a lot of businesses have this hired paid person's opinion. We call them hippo, as you can see here. So this person has an opinion on how the website should look, how it should feel, and what kind of content it should have. But none of these are backed by any rationalization. It's just an opinion of that person.
You can build a website as beautiful and based on hippo's opinion, but that website won't provide expected results from the website. So you need to come up with research and find insight and understand your potential customer and their intent and their behavior so that you can come up with ideal website or the optimal website which resonate for your audience. So actually Reap Digital develop a framework. That framework help you to get insight to build optimal website for your audience.
In order to overcome all the challenges that we mentioned earlier in terms of the hippo opinion or even in terms of it has to be looking beautiful, what we came up with is the Reap Digital Design Framework. So the IRD model is based so that you don't have to face all of these challenges, but it's a systematic way that you can come up with a proper web design that will address your audience and their behavior.
In this framework, you have three pillars: intent, behavior, and design. So you need to start with intent. You need to understand goals and objective of your website. Then you need to understand actually customers or potential customers' intent. What are they looking for, and their persona or their demography.
And when you come to behavior, what you need to understand is how are they behaving on your website, and what outcomes are derived because of these behaviors. And you also need to understand why are people behaving in a certain way. So when you understand all of these three things, you get a very holistic idea of the behavior that needs to come up from your website.
So insight from intent analysis and the behavior analysis, finally you can come up with design architecture. Design architecture means you need to build website architecture based on customer's intent and also their behavior.
When you consider intent, there are three key things that we need to look at. First, business, customer, and the competitor. So when you look at a business, the first thing or the key thing that you need to understand is why does your website exist? What is the reason behind for your website to exist? Is it to generate leads or is it for branding? So what exactly is the outcome or what is the expectation from your website?
You are building the website for your customer, so you need to understand their intent, their persona, their demographic, and what are the information they are looking for, what are the services or product they are looking for.
And finally, you need to look at the competitor. You need to look at what customer segments are the competitor trying to address, and also you need to understand what is the value proposition of your customers.
And you need to understand intent holistically so that you need to look at business intent, customer intent, and competitor intent. And don't limit to employees' opinion or your client's opinion. Go to internet and find research papers or use competitor analytics tool. Then you can come up with holistic intent researches or idea. You need to look at three segments as we discussed. You need to understand business intent, customer intent, and competitor's intent. So this is very important so that you will know your expectation and customer's expectation. Then you utilize these insights or the findings with your customer behavior existing properties. Existing properties could be your website or social profile, so that you need to understand whether your existing properties cater to your customer's intent.
We saw that on our Rabutan e-commerce website that new visitors do not have an intention to buy. Their intention is actually to learn more about the product, surf the website, see if this is what they actually want, and spend time on the website rather than going for a buy as soon as they land.
We wanted to understand the best call to action for the website, because we found that new visitors, they take multiple days before they purchase a product. For example, if they want to purchase a TV, they spend more than 30 days. So based on that, we tried out two call to actions, buy now versus learn more, and we found that if we can show learn more call to action for the new visitors, conversion rate went up and the sales also went up, because they want to explore the product, get the product details and see the pricing and also see any discount codes. Second pillar is that you need to understand your customer's behavior. Under customer's behavior, we need to look at three key areas, which start with web analytics, then you need to understand CRM, and then you need to understand experience. Under web analytics, you can use web analytics tool such as Google Analytics to understand customer behavior, what they look at, what are the pages they go to, what are the leakage point, and also you can use mouse tracking devices or mouse tracking tool or video recording tool to understand your customer's behavior within your website.
And when you look at the CRM data, you can get a clear understanding of similar products they are looking at, or products that you can upsell, cross-sell. So this kind of insights you can get from looking at your CRM data. And then when you look at experience, this is where you can ask your customers, survey them, you can run questionnaires and actually understand why are they behaving in a certain way. For example, why are they buying a certain things together? So once you get that, then the understanding, the behavior becomes holistic. You know the outcomes, you know what made those, what behaviors had resulted in that kind of outcomes, and you also understand why people are behaving in this way.
So once you understood the behavior and the outcome, you can imitate that behavior or the pattern with your website. So the basic example is that Amazon, they suggest product based on your purchase or others' purchase history. So that likewise, you can understand pattern and the outcome and imitate that pattern with your new website. We did an interesting case study with the combining behavior and website designing. We had a client who sells enterprise middleware, and they had a very large article base. We wanted to understand their customer behavior. So we saw that customer comes to article page and they read the article and they left the website. And also we found that customer comes multiple times to the website, and our objective was to understand their next step and how to convert them to a customer.
So what we realize in this analysis is that after their second visit, they take multiple actions. They download products, they download webinars, they download case studies. There are multiple things that they can do. But from our analysis, that we figured out, the action that takes place the most is a product download. So when we dug into our CRM data, we saw that if somebody has downloaded a product, that the chance of them becoming a paying customer is much more higher. So we redesigned the website in a way that when you read an article, that's very easy for you to download the product, which resulted them to get more paying customers.
So without adding a call to action button or very large button on the product page, we actually changed the design and also content to persuade customer to try the product. With the finding from intent research and behavior research, now you can move to design your website architecture. Under design your website architecture, we can actually look at three key areas: technology, psychology, and also design science. Under technology, you need to look at two key things. First one is infrastructure and also website technology. Under website technology, you need to do a research and find what are the technologies you can incorporate with website. It could be a dynamic home page or personalized home page, or it could be a recommendation engine for your e-commerce website. So you need to dig deeper and research with technology and come up with technology and infrastructure suitable for your new website.
There are over 100 of psychological theories that you can use to persuade your customers. So you need to look into those psychological theories and how you can bring them into your website so that you can get more sales or drive more business from your website. And when it comes to design science means different elements of your web design, from color to the fonts and different contexts that are in the design. So for an example, the colors that will be resonating with an adult audience from 55 to 65 will be very different to the colors that will resonate with teenagers. So you need to look at all of these elements, evaluate them, and bring them to your design as well.
With your intent research, behavior research, you can come up with a design architecture. If you have a proper design architecture, then you can justify each element of your website. For example, if someone asks the reason behind your call to action, or the button color, or the font size, you will have reason behind each action you take with the website, so that this will overcome Hippo's idea, or if someone argue that you need to build a beautiful website, because this website came through insight you gain from intent analysis and the behavior analysis.
One of the key challenges that was faced by one of our customers was that not all of their customers had good internet connections. So the technology that we introduced to their website is progressive loading. Progressive loading means that it will load element by element, so we can prioritize which elements need to be loaded first. So let's take, for example, if it's a bank, if you come to the bank site, we can make sure that the contact number or the phone number loads first, so that the person can even give you a call and get the information that they need if the internet connection is not good enough.
And also, we had an e-commerce customer and we wanted to improve their shopping cart purchases, and then we actually use psychology theories to persuade them to complete their order. In the final stage, we used one more step to complete your order. So in that case, we use psychology theory called instant gratification, because everyone loves to get the output instantly. So the moment we added this text, one more step to complete your order, the conversion rate went up and the cart dropout went down. So this is a good example how to use psychological theory. So as Malinda explained, there are more than 100 psychological theories or the triggers you can use. Use that wisely, and you need to test it before use it with website. So test the psychology theory and use it with your new website. Now you have a good understanding about how to build an insight-driven website. Use our framework or similar framework, come up with identify intent and understand behavior, and use intent and behavior with design, and come up with website which can facilitate your potential customers.
Before you start working with an agency to revamp your website, or even if you are currently working with an agency to revamp your website or even to make an entirely new website, there are a few key questions that you can ask them to ensure that you get a website that delivers the right outcomes. So you can click the link below and see all of these questions and reach out to us if you have any further questions on this model or how we have used this model to help businesses around the world.
Don't build most beautiful website to get awards from the award ceremony. Build website for your audiences to get revenue out of your website.
Hope you guys enjoy this Whiteboard Friday, and we'll see you next week. Thank you.